Making Idris Elba 007.
007.
What the fuck?
Yeah,
yeah. Oh, okay.
That was awesome.
I'm sorry, but you scared me for a little bit. I'm like,
I had to get in my role.
Can paralyzed people feel a penis? Find out today at 6.
I don't know what the
find out today at 6. Why'd you say at 6?
Because that's how the news used to be back in the day. Bro, nobody watches the news anymore. TikTok is the news, dog. Before I go, 2024, I want you to call your representative and I want you to tell them.
Drop a nuke.
Drop that nuke.
Drop that nuke.
2024. Yo, stop being responsible.
Everybody, let's admire Craig playing the game and not putting his full effort into the show that you guys are listening to.
You know right what? Little, you know what I gotta do now because I'm losing. I'm playing Clash Royale.
You know what? You know what? This is what we're gonna do. Whoever moves is gay.
Look at it.
You fucking little pussy.
You moved.
Yeah, he's
fantastically gay human being.
Yeah.
Oh my god. For I love those videos.
Love those videos.
Hola, español. Yeah, I saw. Because gay. Are you still moving?
Yeah, he's gay,
you don't gotta move.
I don't know what we're doing.
Whoever moves is gay. Yeah, he's gay.
Bro. Whoa, I just laughed. You can't move.
The way your throat pulsated, you moved, dog.
Yeah, bro.
Don't look at my throat like that. He's a...
What throat, Craig?
Whoever has glasses is gay.
What throat?
I'm sorry, bro.
I don't know why all of these things come out of my head.
It's fine.
I do love you, though.
Those are the best parts.
I love you so much, bro.
I love you too.
God damn it.
I love you.
God damn it.
How was your guys' weekend?
It was good. Cold.
What's up with this weather, bro?
It was good weather this weekend.
No. Last week was like 70s, 60s.
Yeah,
I don't know where it goes. This whole week is like 30s. 40s?
Yeah, but this is like get you sick weather. Everybody gets sick whenever the weather changes for some reason. That's when the fucking plague hits and everybody's
You guys think we get depressed or our mood goes down because of the weather?
Yes.
Yeah. It's scientifically proven. It's seasonal depression.
How'd you felt when you went to PR?
What? Amazing.
Fantastic. Then you came back to the US. What happened?
Why am I here? Why am I in this concentration
camp? I went in DR, it was beautiful. Are we depressed because we're in the United States? Is depression just like a mind thing?
But that is a truth. That is true, though. Like, you think people in Europe feel like that? Like when they like people, somebody in Italy that has like a fucking little store that sells bread.
No,
like you think that. He's like, let me go to from Italy. He's like, let me go to France, right? He goes to France for like a weekend. He comes back. You think he feels like shit like we do?
The weekend. How big do you think Europe is?
It's like a 45-minute
thing. But Italy, from Italy to France is like nothing.
It's 45 minutes. Yeah. And that's what I'm saying. In U.S., for us to get to L.A., it's like, what, 6 hours?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Are you telling me Europe can fit in the United States of America?
Yeah.
I think not whole Europe.
But if every country's 45 minutes away from each other by train?
Majority of them are.
But also, I think everybody on the, what is it, the West? The East.
Yeah.
The East of the globe. Why do they get the East? You know what I mean?
We're the West
side of the planet.
Yeah.
But what if we start from there? We're the East side and then the West side.
No.
What is that West? The West only have water, right?
No. The West is America's.
But it doesn't matter because if the East, which is New York, you look at keep looking at the East, you're going to get Europe. But if you're looking at the West, you're like on Los Angeles, whatever. You look at the West, you look that way. You're still gonna get to the East. You understand?
If you keep going west, you'll go to the East. Correct.
Yeah. If you're in Japan,
that's because
if you're in Japan, you're looking at the East,
and you look East,
and you end up in
who's
West.
There, us, America. Mm. Why are we the East, the West? I don't want to be the West. I want to be the East.
Why?
But we're the Western civilization.
You literally are the East. You're here in the East Coast of the United States.
But we're considered the Western civilization to the East.
Oh, because they started first. Okay, I
guess. We are in the Western side of the world, yes.
It's like twins. The older one is the one that came out first.
This is not like twins.
Yeah. They came out first.
West and East is not like twins.
Yeah.
Because those are just directions.
Yeah, but the only reason the Eastern civilization exists is because they discovered the West second.
Is that why people say that, like, oh, everything went left, meaning that everything went to shit?
We went to the Western.
Everything, because if you keep thinking about it, when we went from East to the West, everything just kept going to shit. Like, look at us now in America. Right? Everything's shit. Over there right now is probably like flowers and shit right now.
Mm-hmm. Flowers, that's why, like, Scotland.
Bro, you go to Rome, Sweden. You can see a tower tilting. You go to fucking France, you can see a beautiful fucking pyramid.
You go to Egypt,
you see a beautiful pyramid with a sand. You go here, you go to New York, you see a fucking time rat.
No, I gotta cut you off real quick.
And then you go to LA, you just see a fucking red bridge. What is that? Nobody cares about a red bridge.
Hear me out. Italy has a tilting building.
Yeah.
You see a tilting building in America? Yo, you're failing inspection.
Yeah.
I'm putting fines all over that shit. And people take pictures of that shit. Come to America and take pictures of that fucking tilting building here.
Every time they take pictures, they do that hell Hitler shit.
Who?
What are you talking about?
All the people that take the pictures?
Who?
Holding the... I don't want to do it.
What are you talking about?
The people that take the pictures holding the tower in Italy. They're doing the hell Hitler.
Or they got the morning wood where they're laying on the ground.
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck?
Facts.
But you know what I'm talking about? There's more interesting shit over there than here. Like, everything interesting started, and as the humanity kept moving west.
Left.
To the left. Everything just kept going to shit. Like, now all we make is buildings, blocks. You know what I'm saying? We're just making rectangles.
So what do you want?
Cubes.
Circles on the ground.
That's all we're doing, yeah.
Or buildings.
Yeah, we just... Our buildings, if you think about it, our buildings are just big-ass cubes. That's all they are, bro.
Big-ass Legos.
That's all it is. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Everything else stopped. And then out of nowhere, one guy's like, let me build a red bridge. And then, because the Empire State Building, the Statue of Liberty is not from us.
We got gifted, bro. Maybe we've been tracked and fucking this whole year because there's something in the Statue of Liberty. Why did it turn green? It was supposed to be copper.
Well, that's because of the weather and time. Come on, guy.
I understand.
No, that means the French are some pieces of shit. They couldn't give us something that was good.
Facts.
It was good. We just didn't know how to take care of it. We didn't maintain it.
You know,
we can literally go and restore it, but we just don't.
Yeah, but all over the world, people know the Statue of Liberty
as green.
Yeah.
But
it used to be copper.
Yo, I give you a gift, right? Mm-hmm. Shoes. They break apart. What are you doing? You fixing them?
No, I'm throwing it out.
Get rid of that statue. We get rid of that statue. But what
throwing it out the window.
But hear me out now. What if, right? Because the world knows it's as green, right?
Yeah.
What if it's green because it represents money and it represents capitalism? And that's what the real... It's not Liberty. Lady Liberty. Mm. It's Lady... Damn. I can't think of a money word.
Lady
capitalism. Liability? Lady Liability.
Oh, lady
Liability, dog. Mm-hmm. Yo, bring back my boy, because gold never turns green, dog.
You know what? When I came in here, I was like, I should move that statue, because it's not good to have an extra.
He's going to drop every episode.
Every episode, bro. That's annoying.
I don't like that answer. There's going to be a bloodbath.
Jesus.
Yo, wild times we're living in. Imagine that, yo. What do you think is going to happen in November?
See, that's why we gotta take.
I don't know, but it's gonna be like,
a bloodbath.
Interesting, very interesting.
You heard those words, right?
Mm-hmm. I heard those
bloodbath.
Words. Bloodbath.
Who's blood?
Mm-hmm.
We Crip out here, dog.
Did you guys see the new Elon Musk? Did you see the Neuralink shit?
Big woo.
Did you see it?
No, I haven't seen it. No.
Dude, what? The Neuralink.
The Neuralink, they got it out now.
No, yeah, they have videos of the guy using it. And he's moving the computer with his brain.
I don't believe that
shit. How do I know that's not somebody in another room moving a mouse?
How do I not know Hezbollah's in the back moving the mouse? You can see Hezbollah.
Let's see the guy. You got a video?
Anyway, so what else you guys want to talk about then?
But you can show the video.
Let's look at this Neuralink.
Let me see.
I don't like the word Neuralink.
Why?
It's too long.
But it makes sense, though.
Why can't it just be Nora?
Neuralink.
Ooh. Or Link. No, Link is too easy.
Neuralinga.
Well, Link is because it's linked. It makes sense.
Neuralink.
Intuitive for me to start imagining the cursor moving. Basically,
why is he sitting like that? Like, he can't move?
Using paralyzed. The force.
Don't forget.
The cursor.
Man, I'm sorry.
Don't forget, he picked the guy that can't move his limbs.
Yeah.
and I could get it to move wherever I wanted. Just stare somewhere in the screen, and it would move where I wanted to.
All right, move on.
Which was...
Dude, this is literally a 20-second video.
But I can't see him move shit.
Jeez, he was moving it at first.
It just became intuitive for me to start imagining the cursor moving. Basically, it was like using the force on a cursor, and I could get it to move wherever I wanted. Just stare somewhere in the screen, and it would move where I wanted to.
That's how it felt.
Which was such a wild... I think it just became intuitive for me to...
Keep it playing, keep it playing. Okay, so look, I have two things. Pause it. Keep going. Jesus. Sorry, retention span. We got this. Look. Look at the guy to his left. Right there. Pause. His hand's up his ass. And he's using him like a fucking puppet.
His hand is in the back.
Not up his ass. Like a ventriloquist, bro.
Your ass is down here.
Okay, but guess what?
He has his hand through here.
All right, he has him in the back. But also, look, you never see the other side of the head. How fucked up is that side of the head to do that bullshit? How's it look, dog? You get a quick preview when it goes to the end, and it goes, I saw a green-ass cord.
I pulled up the thing. It's a longer video, a nine-minute video that they put officially.
That looks like Topher Grace from the That 70s Show.
Right?
Who's Topher Grace?
But this is when they went live, and they showed the guy moving the thing. The clip I just showed you guys is from clipped out from this.
Oh, so then they definitely had to.
Things that y'all have enabled me to do something that.
Wow, that's super cool, though.
I like the cock ring underneath the.
You saw that shit.
So now my thing is, what if he wants? Can he still masturbate with his? How is he gonna do that?
But I thought he couldn't move his limbs.
Yeah, he can't move his limbs, right?
So those people that can't move the limbs, can they move their dick?
She's like 8 hours
maybe.
A day.
You've moved your dick before, right?
I can control my limbs.
Restriction at the thing, Neuralink.
Okay.
I can do it with or without. I can't do it on command, though.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, if you're sending... We'll go back to this. But, like, if you're hard and you're sending like this, and you're like... That shit's going to move. Yeah.
It pumps.
Can he
pump
that?
Depends how paralyzed he is. I don't know.
So people that are paralyzed, when they say, I heard, like, waist down, dick too?
Sometimes.
Possibly.
Sometimes.
Yeah.
How do they get pleasure?
And then again, your dick is a muscle, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like,
we can find
it
out.
It is not a limb, though.
No, it's not.
Is it?
No.
It is popping out of your fucking... body.
You have four limbs. Black men have five. Other than that, we only got four limbs, man.
We only got four limbs. That's true.
We can easily find out how they can get pleasure, but we are definitely not going to get anything off of this video. The video,
if you're paralyzed from
down,
the waist down, is it still possible to blah, blah, blah?
You could just look up at a certain website instead of Twitter. I'm sure they got a category.
Can people feel their penis, it says there.
Where?
And it says, can paralyzed people feel their penis? Up, there. Down.
That's the paralyzed guy telling the lady to keep stroking his shit.
Up, down.
It says most males cannot feel their penises.
Oh, damn.
Who is this guy for us to be like, trust him with everything right now? I don't know.
Hold up. It says it does not mean that their penises are non-functional. However, they can still experience erections. They are not associated.
Yo, imagine me like not being able to feel my dick, but I can see it go up.
And somebody else feeling it.
That might be fucking crazy.
Trippy. Because like, somebody else is feeling it. Somebody else is like, you know.
What?
Hold on.
You don't feel it.
Now, you can't feel your dick, but can you feel the erection?
No.
That's two different things.
What do you mean?
The ejaculation, sorry. Can you feel that ejaculation?
You must.
That's two different things, bro. Because if that's possible, we might have entered a whole different territory right now, bro.
No, you must not.
Because imagine somebody's masturbating you and you don't feel anything out of nowhere. Whoa, no. You feel like the explosion out of nowhere. You feel the explosion. That must feel insane, bro.
Insane, bro.
Guess what? we don't have to wonder because we can do it ourselves.
We can, but I'm just wondering hypothetically.
When you jack off, you feel your fucking dick.
So it's like a cannon, is what you're saying.
So they don't feel it, but then when ejaculation is about to happen, something must be like, you know, you feel that, like, oh, she's about to, I'm about to come. And then, but them.
I'm going
to
come.
Yeah, I'm going to come. But them, they don't feel the muscle or the penis. They just feel the, I'm coming out now.
So that's making me wonder now, right? You know, when you fall asleep, when something falls asleep on you and it's numb, you don't like that feeling, right?
Yeah.
It's that tingly shit. Do quadriplegics. Happens every night. Where?
Arm.
Yeah, me too.
Hands.
What's up with that? Like certain fingers?
Certain fingers.
What's up with that, dog?
Well, that's, you because, guys that's get... because we're sleeping on top of our arms and fingers, bro. Why else?
Bro, I be waking up. And
but
like...
you know why, right? Because you're cutting the circulation of your arm while, like, if you're laying on it, you're cutting the
it
circulation.
It pisses me off. I wake up and, like, these three specific fingers are numb. Or these two are numb. And I'm like...
Dude, when you... not gonna lie, sometimes it feels kind of cool. I just don't like the tinkling. But sometimes I wake up and I'm just like this.
One day I fell asleep, whatever, and then I woke up. I was like, and I tried to lift myself up, and I was like, boom, boom. I fell back. I'm like, what the fuck? And then I just, oh, fuck.
Just a lifeless body.
Yeah, I was like, oh, what the fuck? Ugh. That shit feels good, though. Yeah,
no, it doesn't.
It feels a little weird.
I hate
it
that
good.
Shit.
It feels a bit good.
But once it starts coming back, it's like, huh. There you are.
Yeah, I'm not dying.
Yeah.
Usually what you should do is just put your arm up.
Yeah, but you can even... So you need to,
maybe.
You just got to put your arm up. Or like when I feel like a cramp on my... cramp. When I feel that on my leg, like it's falling asleep, I usually just put my legs up. Pause.
Your leg fall asleep when you take a shit?
No.
If you're there for a long time, do you have to?
Has it ever?
Has my leg ever fallen asleep in any other scenario?
On my knees. I'm like this on my knees.
While taking a shit on your knees?
No, you fucking shit.
Like your arm like on
this?
Your knees.
Oh, yeah, yeah, like this.
Yeah.
And then I'm like,
oh, shit, what the fuck?
It has fallen asleep, but my legs have fallen asleep besides taking a shit, like, in another scenario.
What scenario?
Like, when I have my legs like, crossed.
You have your legs crossed?
Yeah, for too long. Do you sit like that?
No, my thighs are too big.
Like, ever. When's the last time you sat like that?
You get a rug, bro.
How crossed are we talking?
Fully crossed.
Fully
you
crossed?
Talking about like Indian style?
I don't know why they have their like designated leg crossers. I don't know why you think that, but wait, sure.
Or are you talking about I'm sitting on a couch, one leg's over the other?
Bro, it's not that complicated. You cross your fucking legs. I don't understand.
Like, you're crossing
how
your
hard
leg.
Is that to explain? Like you're crossing your legs, bro. Like you're crossing your leg.
So Indian style.
I guess. Sure, Craig.
Yeah.
Who you are
now? Racist!
Who you are now? When's the last time you done that?
When my kid was doing wrestling, I was just sitting on the mat, but my leg didn't fall asleep. No, actually, yeah. I had to like move and readjust and have one leg out and then the other leg bent like that shit. Yeah. Yeah. It was all right.
Do you do it often?
Yeah, but you know, fall asleep here and there if I'm like for a long time.
Yeah.
So, like, as a quadriplegic, are you like that all the time?
What does that mean?
Do you feel that tingling, numb sensation all over your body?
Quadriplegic?
He doesn't know that word.
That's the motherfucker you just watched with a cock ring on his
laptop. I don't think he feels numbness. He just doesn't feel the legs.
No, he doesn't feel anything. It's like his head is floating. Whoa. Yeah.
Damn, imagine that.
So, I don't think he feels anything when he... Blow!
Like the Futurama, remember the heads used to be in like
in the jars.
Yeah,
I think that's gonna happen. How? I don't know.
Might happen.
But you know what's crazy though?
What?
You're a quadriplegic, right?
Mm.
You just want to know what it's like. How do you go about asking the first person to beat you off? That's awkward,
bro. You know how many people you can pay to do that, and they will do it.
Oh, is that like a fetish? Maybe.
Imagine you're a hooker, right? And you're just like working the corner, all these sleaze bags or whatever.
And a guy in a wheelchair pulls up.
Oh, fucking fuck he's like, me. Can you're gonna up the price.
No, he's like, can you please talk
no, to we're me. Not talking about what's his name?
Stephen Hawking.
Yeah, not Stephen Hawking. Stephen Hawking wouldn't go for that. He would just go to fucking Epstein's Island.
Or maybe they're nice and they're like, you know what? I know you can't do shit. I'm going to give you a discount. What do you think? I think it determines who you are as a person, what you think they're going to do.
I'll charge you for half a body.
Half a body.
Half a body.
Yeah, but it's
half
just,
body. Because they can touch you.
You're not fucking the body. You're
just touching the dick. Yeah, but they're perfect for like strippers.
I don't understand why it's half off because of the body. Still has a body, you just can't feel it.
But look, I thought it was something hilarious, but then I thought, oh wait, that turned into rape, dog.
Oh my god.
So imagine you're the hooker. A guy pulls up in that wheelchair. He's like, yeah, I can't do nothing from the neck down, yada yada. Can you help me out? She's like, yeah, sure. While they're doing it, out of nowhere, he just goes, and I was like, wait,
like, bitch.
Psych.
Yeah, nah,
yo,
that's crazy.
That's crazy.
That's fucked. That probably happens.
I'm not proud of this.
Yeah, no.
But yeah, it was a hypothetical thought, dog.
That's a crazy thought, though.
Mm-hmm.
That's a really great bad idea for serial killers. Let me tell you. Great bad idea for sure.
No, it's a great idea.
What would but you... also bad.
Wait, serial killer, though, you can't do that because you can't get away with that.
Why not?
Like, serial...
You come in.
Our word.
Yeah, I want to, you know. Oh, sure, sure. Yeah, just follow me. And you're like, okay. And then you turn around and you're like, yeah, boom. And then you...
Mm-hmm. Well, first of all, is this how you think? Like, you just walk up to somebody, hey, follow me, and they're just going
to
follow
you? No, you go to a prostitute. A prostitute's going to get in the fucking... She want the money.
And you just got to roll out in that same wheelchair?
Well, that's why that job is very dangerous. Very dangerous.
It's a very honest job, I must say.
I asked somebody this earlier, right? Why are strip clubs still a thing when you have OnlyFans?
Because in OnlyFans, you can't touch them. In strip clubs, you can.
It's the bada bing, you know?
Mm-hmm. That's true. Okay.
And in OnlyFans, you can't be like, yo, can I get a lap dance? You'd be like, can I just have a picture that you're going to look at for 20 minutes? Not even 20 minutes. 1 second. You're going to be like, damn, this is tough. But then, like, already that little thing that made you, like,
the dopamine
excited you for like that 1 second is gone. That's why you keep asking for more. Mm. You know what I'm saying?
I got you.
In the strip club, you just go and bust a nut for a whole hour and you're good. I mean, I don't think people bust nuts in strip clubs. But you know what I mean? Like you go and you get yourself excited for an hour.
I think a lot of dudes do.
Nah, I don't know.
Will you eat from the strip club?
I've ate from
one. I heard they got good food. Mm-hmm. They got good food?
From one that I went before, yeah, I ate. That's because I went early and they were still serving dinner. Okay. So they were like half restaurant, half strip club. Yeah.
Half restaurant, half strip club.
Yeah, they have tables in the back.
Hooters?
No, that's not.
My question now is when you're eating, do the strippers come up to you and ask you? Like, hey, what's up?
No.
They leave you alone?
No, they never came up to me. I don't know if they do. But they're just there dancing.
What's up?
Like, yeah.
Let's get it on.
That would be kind of dirty.
Are you the stripper or the guy eating? Yo, what's up? Let's get it on. Like, what? I'm picturing P over here like this. Hey, come in. Put a dollar in it.
But that's dirty, right? You're touching tits that she's rubbed dollars all over. And then on top of that, you're also like touching this bitch that she's probably had. Guys that touched her, that were touching their penis with sperm on their penis all over her.
But not too many guys not in your world.
Why?
What did you say? In the strip clubs, nobody does it.
Oh, yeah, you're right. But apparently you guys are confirming that they do.
Give or take, yeah. But I was wondering, like, how is that also working, too? Because, you know, people don't really use cash nowadays.
Oh, the,
that's true.
We're just using numbers. The strip club is known for you to throw. You have to bring cash.
How do you guys think dads feel when their daughters become a stripper?
You would never know because they were never around.
Ooh.
Think about it.
Talking about dads.
Ah.
Best dad ever on TV shows, cartoons.
We went over this before.
I don't want to be the guy to ruin you. I want him to keep going. All
right.
Best dad on TV shows, cartoons. Everything else.
Danny Tanner.
Goku.
Why?
Piccolo.
Thanks. Why?
I had a debate this weekend.
with a group of friends. I think Goku was a good dad. Even though he wasn't there for Gohan. He asked Piccolo to kill him so his son can live. Mm-hmm. But then I remember there's like an episode where Gohan wants, I think, gives him a present or some shit like that. So that's where it comes. Dad is the ones erased, not necessarily the ones that.
You know why that's all gone?
Why?
Because at some point in the show, Gohan wears Piccolo's fit the entire saga, dog.
Mm-hmm.
When he was facing Cell, he had Piccolo's fit on, dog.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
He wore the stepdad's fit. The
stepdad's, bro.
Piccolo black. I'm telling you that right
I
now.
I was just going to ask.
Piccolo?
Why was Piccolo? Was Piccolo fucking black? White? What?
I said Piccolo.
Wasn't he green?
Huh?
Wasn't he green?
Yeah, but he black, dog.
Literally. No.
He black.
No. That question is...
black. Piccolo no. black.
Yeah, fat. But yo, the build, how tall he looks and everything. Black, bro.
Bro. He's literally green. This is not a black and white.
No, show. I know. But like,
it's a color show.
I know, but if we turn them into humans, just like when they turn the Simpsons or the Family Guys into humans, like the AI, I think he'll be black.
I'm gonna tell you this too. Piccolo is more black than Mr. Popo. Mr. Popo, Lord knows
Popo
what he is.
Mr. Popo is Asian.
Mr. Popo is something that is unacceptable. But Piccolo is black.
Thanks, bro.
Okay.
Shout out to Black History Month. It's middle of March.
What?
We love
what
the blacks.
What is going on?
We love the blacks.
Jesus.
Shout out to Akira Toriyama.
So what you think? Like, I think Goku was a good dad.
Yo, he gave that man a sensu bean. His boy.
He what?
He gave Cell a sensu bean. You know why, though? I think now I know. Because he realized, he's like, I'm going to train my son to be the best Super Saiyan ever, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then what did he do after? They were wearing Vegeta's fit,
yes,
right? They weren't wearing fucking Goku shit.
Uh-huh.
Then after that shit, guess what? He wore Piccolo shit. Goku said, yo, I'm not going to train you to be the best motherfucker ever, and you're going to wear this other man's fucking fit.
So Gohan never found himself?
So hear me out. So he said, you know what? Fuck this kid. Cell, here's a sensu bean. Fuck this motherfucker up.
But it was to teach him a lesson.
Yeah, don't ever wear another man's fit in front of me, dog.
Goku was playing God, just like God plays with like Gaza and all this shit.
No.
Like, oh, do you want to, you know what? Learn a lesson.
No, he was playing a I take that back. I was going to say a responsible father. An angry-ass father. That's what he played.
He was an angry-ass father, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Hmm. Pick a little black Goku. What's your take on this, Pete?
Listening, it's interesting.
Great guy, right here. Character, you know, amazing guy.
Yeah. I don't know. I think
best TV character.
That's a father.
Best
figure.
Father figure.
What about Peter from Family Guy?
Absolutely not.
He's the worst father. That's
worst
literally
father, right.
Yeah. Either it's been like between him and
the Simpsons, the guy from Omero.
Bro, you know what?
Homer.
Excuse me. I don't know.
You know what annoys me about this shit? The Family Guy shit?
What?
I feel like kids nowadays, I'm kind of changing the subject at this point.
Okay.
But it's related to Family Guy. I feel like this generation that's coming up right now does not watch anything. They don't watch movies. They don't watch cartoon shows. They just get all their references from videos that make references to all these shows. So they know about the show in little moments, but they don't know the show.
It's because of the clips, movies, the shorts, yeah, the Instagram, yeah, the, you know what I mean? That's why.
That is so true, because our spam, like, what is that, short spam?
Attention span.
It's so dead, bro. It's like so dead. Like, even if you like look at music, right? Music is now like a minute, 20 seconds long. Like most songs that are coming out now, they're like 2 minutes long, tops. Back then, they were like 4 minutes. You know what I'm saying?
Same beat that repeats itself.
Yeah, and even before that, bro, it was like, it used to be like 6 minutes in the 70s and shit.
That's wild.
You know
they
what
have
I'm
long
saying?
Ass intros.
Yeah, bro, and now it's like 2 minutes, 1 minute long, and it's all just to fit this fucking system, this fucking internet has built.
You think you're the shit? You're not even that far.
Yeah.
I've been going hard. You saw the tour video?
It's I Spies, bro.
I'm being really hard.
Sorry, bro.
But it's and it's the same thing. Like even with even like the superhero movies kind of dumbed us down a little bit. And I'm glad that people reacted to it the way they did, because now like Marvel pulled back. They're like, all right, we're gonna stop releasing all this shit. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And then we got shit like Oppenheimer now. You know what I'm saying? We got people that want to actually go see movies and they're making movies, masterpieces.
I thought you were gonna say something else.
What?
Masturbators.
No.
Nah, but yo, shout out to Marvel for stopping that shit, because they pissed me off, dog.
Yeah, because they were just dropping too much of that shit, and people were like, they were getting accustomed to it, and now that's all they expected.
Yo, Craig, you know how do you feel about Dr. Xavier being black?
What?
He's not
black. Is
this
real, dog?
Nah, it's not confirmed or nothing.
What?
But people were just saying that they think he should be the guy from Breaking Bad. What's his name?
Why?
The black guy from Breaking Bad.
Because he's a good... The way I see
Well, he's Latino, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The way
I see him, like the way he acts, he kind of acts like Dr. Xavier.
Tell me a role that he's been the good guy.
No.
Exactly. No. Done. He might as well make a Magneto.
But technically, to a lot of people, Magneto is the good guy. And Dr. Xavier is the bad guy.
There certain roles that should stay? I don't know how to say this. Like,
yes.
For example, on Snow White.
There's certain roles that should stay like that, like Black Panther.
Yeah.
That should stay to black people.
Like fucking, what's the fish? The human and the fish?
Yeah.
Little Mermaid?
Yeah.
But why should they stay there? She's not real. There's no culture behind it. Like Black Panther is cultural. It's like black culture. So yes, it should be to a black, like a Shogun.
Yeah.
It should be to an Asian guy.
Yes.
But there's no culture behind, like for example, what's his name? The guy, the fucking 007? No. Who was it?
James Bond.
There's no culture behind James Bond. You know what I'm saying? It's not like...
Yeah, and they switched it to the... I forget his name.
Idris Elba.
Yeah, that one was fire.
That'd be a good movie.
But it came out, no?
No. Never did. Never will.
Why not? I think I would like that.
Because the whites don't like that shit.
Wait, which one? Which one are you talking about?
Making Idris Elba 007.
007.
What the fuck is Idris Elba? That's the black bald guy.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That was awesome.
I'm sorry, but you scared me for a little bit. I'm like,
I had to get in my role.
But then as soon as you said that, I was like, okay. Eventually I caught on. But at first I really thought you were joking.
First he thought it was like, what?
He was like,
I was like, what the fuck? That's your reaction.
What
the
fuck? That shit was hilarious.
I think he would have been a good one too, but I don't think they're gonna make it, right?
They should.
I think that was just people talking. I don't think it's actually maybe.
But
that'd
be good though.
The same thing with Dr. Xavier, it's just people talking. I don't think it's really gonna happen.
I was gonna say, give me a show where like it was specifically a certain race, but if you change it to another race, it'd be a better show.
Breaking Bad.
What race?
Where?
The main character.
Okay, they're white, but like, what would you change?
Actually, that's perfect because white people are men. You know, they show like, especially being a school teacher, they're like.
So what? Black people can't be a school teacher.
What about Hispanics?
I'm not saying that.
The Asian people can't be a school teacher. It's great at math.
It's a white guy that's a teacher, and then turns bad.
But Asian guys are great at what he was in, like a chemist, right? Uh-huh. He was a. That's why it's called Breaking Bad.
My chemistry teacher in high school was Cuban, dog.
Mm. That's why you turned out to.
He worked with the Russians, bro. He worked with the Russians, bro. Be careful with that.
Shit, dog. If he dies, he dies. shit.
Talking about the Russians, yo. I was watching a documentary. I still don't know the name. On Netflix. It just came out. About Stalin and fucking Hitler and what's the other guy's name? What's the other Russian guy?
China.
Well, China was getting fucked.
Yeah, honestly,
at that time in World War I and World War II, they were just trying to get fucked. Like, let's see who conquered you.
Yeah. What the fuck was that?
Because I knew if I did what I wanted to do, E would look at me like, what the fuck?
He was telling me earlier today.
I'm not bored.
Earlier, he was telling me about that documentary, right? And he was mentioning the atomic bomb and shit. Uh-huh. Right? He said that they deserved it.
Ooh!
Hiroshima
deserved
it.
Oh, shit!
We got a racist in the building!
When? No, I didn't.
I wanted to get your opinion. Do you think they deserved it?
Ooh, the Japanese?
Yeah.
From what I heard, I saw a video that they were doing a lot of fuck shit. Lot of fuck shit, dog. They were fucking up everybody. I'm assuming they said that in the documentary.
I didn't say shit! I didn't say shit!
I was like, he lied to me, so I could come out and say that. Yeah. Piece of shit, it worked.
Yo, the fucking Japanese, they went and they bombed Pearl Harbor.
And which then is fucking fair play in the war.
And then fucking USA went and he's like, you know what? How many people died in Pearl Harbor?
12.
Stop. 12? No, I think it was like 3,000 or something.
Let's just say 10,000.
All right, let's say 20.
Let's say 50,000.
We said 10,000.
Let's just say 50,000 people died in per hour, okay? USA came back and said, hey, let's kill millions. Fuck it. They went and killed them. And they fucking, what I found out, too, is that in America, there were concentration camps. For Asian people.
Like, we were killing them?
Nah,
them
bro. There were American Japanese people that were born here or that were naturalized, whatever the fuck it is. And they went to their homes, the army or the government, the U.S., they went to their homes, like in Jersey. They went to, like, Fort Lee, right?
What?
They went to Fort Lee.
What?
They took them out of their houses.
No way.
And put them in concentration camps.
Fort Lee?
No, I'm just giving you an example.
Oh, I'm like, damn, they fucked them up. they didn't do shit because they're loaded with them right now.
You know what I mean? Like, they just took them on. They put in concentration camps for 4 years, bro. Just because they were Japanese.
What'd they do?
Nothing. They didn't do nothing.
But they weren't just Japanese people. If you looked Japanese.
Damn, so a lot of Peruvians got sent over there.
A lot of Asian people, yeah. Do we look Japanese?
He's like, you piece of shit.
But all those people got picked up. They were like, yo, you got get a couple of fucking clothes. Let's go. They took them out of their houses and everything. They gave their houses all the people and they fucking put them in concentration camps just because they were Asian.
So what you're saying is he believes they deserved it.
No, what I'm saying is this is what I should have said. What did Hitler do?
Put the people of a certain ethnicity.
Jewish people.
Yes.
In concentration camps.
Yeah.
And then he was persecuted all over the world.
America saw him doing that. They were like,
not him, but the Nazis were persecuted all over the world.
Please don't, bro.
Right? Listen to me.
I'm listening.
This is very important. Don't play with this.
I'm listening, dog.
All over the world. Bam. And then Stalin... Was it Stalin? Yeah, Stalin, right? Mm. That's another one. Then Stalin went and he lied to the Russian people and used the Russian people as slaves to build the new fucking communism in Russia. And they didn't persecute Stalin at all. They didn't persecute the USA at all. They persecuted the Germans, the Nazis. Why? Because it was an N-word?
What?
Because of an N-word?
Nazis.
Okay. You cannot just say N-word to that.
I thought Obama was like that back then. Like, whoa.
Yeah, I'm like, why are you saying the N-word?
Your head is somewhere else, bro. I'm just saying.
Yeah, you're racist, Craig.
Yeah, you're racist.
Yeah, the gaslight here is wild, dog. We don't do this shit, dog.
I know. Everybody listen, I confuse the shit out of them, bro.
I thought somebody was.
And some people probably like, yeah. Wait, no. Oh, they were racist for a little bit right now.
Yeah.
But we're all in there together.
Yeah. But you know what I mean? Like, that's crazy. Like, you know, hey, I'm not justifying that, you know, what the Germans did was right. But if they got persecuted.
So should America.
So should America and fucking the Russians.
Asian people in concentration camps.
You know what I mean?
But instead, we put them in concentration camps and we were just like, let's throw a little you know, a little bomb in there.
Yo,
you guys still fucking with me? Okay, here's another one.
Did millions of people die in the atomic bomb drop?
Yeah. I think twice, bro.
Nah, I don't think a million people died, but
I think hundreds of thousands.
And also, how big is Japan compared to America? Is it the size of a state? Is it like the size of California?
I don't know. We're about to find out. How many people died in that fucking bomb?
Let's see. Atomic bombs. Hiroshima.
Why do you have to be so specific when it's only been dropped a couple times on history?
Two times, yeah. Because it didn't pop up.
Counting the dead at Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
It says here 70,000 Hiroshima and 40,000 Nagasaki, 110,000. But that's only the data on the impact. But over time, with people that got all of the, what is that called?
200.
Hear me out. Say 200. That's a football stadium. Big deal.
Oh my God.
We got a lot of humans in this place.
Drulak.
Well, I know. Maybe. So now, you know, when they say there's going to be, we're going to destroy the world by shooting nukes all over the world and shit. If one only takes out 100,000, we got 8 billion. Drop a couple. Just don't hit me.
It's not realistic.
Here. Boom. One's for you. One for you. One for.
Shut up, bitch.
300 million people on fucking America. You drop one nuke, you took out one stadium, dog. That's like destroying every single football stadium on this planet. So I don't give a fuck what you say. We can drop a couple nukes anywhere on this fucking planet.
Anyway, if we really wanted to, we could do whatever the fuck we could do.
You know what, Kim Jong-un? I release your sanction. Play with them toys, dog. Throw them around. Fucking shit up. Let's do it. 2024, we're dropping nukes everywhere, dog.
Yo, shut the fuck up.
Everywhere.
The guy walking outside in the hallway. He's just
Let's
like, what the
fucking
fuck?
Go. Russia, Vladimir, you don't, yo, you got protesters saying get the fuck off for your fifth term. Drop another nuke, dog.
Drop one.
Just throw it in the ocean.
Ukraine?
You got one? Throw another one. Just throw everything. Everything. You're only killing. Kobe, do it. R.I.P. Kobe, dog.
R.I.P. Kobe.
Yeah. R.I.P. Before I go, 2024, I want you to call your representative, and I want you to tell them.
Drop a nuke.
Drop that nuke.
Drop that nuke.
2024.
I, Craig, approve this message.
Drop that, Craig.
This is why you guys should not make a podcast if you have friends.
Yo, I'm sorry, but I have to say this. You were talking, right?
Uh-huh.
But then as soon as that anthem came in, everything just became worse.
Makes it better.
Yeah, and a little racist.
Not gonna lie. Like at first you were saying like yeah, we should like drop the bomb something, but then when the American anthem came in, I kind of was feeling the patriotism. I was like, you know what? Yeah.
USA, bitch. USA. Tell me you're not American.
None of this made in Vietnam. None of this made in fucking, what is it, Honduras. None of this made in Mexico.
I promise you, Honduras makes none of that.
Yo, no, they make something. They
play a song again. We can hear a song now.
Oh, my God.
Go.
America.
America.
You go to Walmart, Target. You go anywhere, H&M, wherever you buy your clothes. Look at that tag. What does it say?
How many countries you count?
Made from Vietnam.
Uh-huh.
Made from El Salvador.
Right.
Made from Nicaragua. Man.
What is that?
I don't know. I want my shit homegrown.
Facts.
I want to know what's in my food.
Facts.
I want to know what chemicals are in those shirts.
Biochemical.
I want the dollar menu back at McDonald's.
No more 444. No more that Wendy shit, bro.
You're not
That's
slick.
What's important to this
four
guy.
Four by four.
Not the economic depression that we're going
through.
No,
stop. Fix the ice cream machine.
The ice cream machines, you fixed them. Yes. But 4x4 Wendy's, that's 16.
Uh-huh.
I know math.
Facts.
I went to school. We got the American education system.
Taco Bell is America.
Taco Bell is dog food in a tortilla. Because we don't condone that Mexican shit.
Yeah. I'm going to be honest, bro. At first,
we WBS support this message.
We cracked. At first, when you were being all that, I was like, okay, this is going somewhere. You could have mentioned, you know, all these wars you don't want to be in no more. You know, you could have mentioned, you know, all of these, the gas is going up. You could have mentioned the gas is going up. Yo, can we lower down the gases? You're like, oh, yo, my milk is going up. Yo, can we lower down the milk? You know what I'm saying?
But you know what's the best part?
Yo, the houses, they're so expensive now. Like, no. This guy decided to mention the fucking dollar menu.
Okay,
bro.
But look, hear me out. Play that shit again and say that with that, and it's going to be 1,000 times
put
better.
It,
you can say anything with the national anthem, and that shit makes sense, right, and it's amazing.
Right. Right. Do it this, right. do it my message, do it my way.
Go. Yo, ladies and gentlemen, America, we're back again. Because we have not one, not two, but 50 stars.
Facts.
50 states.
Probably 51 with Puerto Rico, but we don't count it.
Couple of territories.
Maybe.
Let them go. We don't need them.
No.
We don't need... What does Puerto Rico give us?
Bad, I don't know.
Bad Bunny?
That's it.
The fuck?
Hey, what we need that? Bad Bunny.
We got rabbits in America. Homegrown fresh.
Wild bunnies.
USDA approved.
Facts.
GMO gone.
Gone.
Yo.
They also gave us Ricky Martin.
Fuck that shit.
He fucked his cousin. I don't know where we should go with this.
Allegedly. What I'm saying is... The whole point of this conversation was because my boy here, P, wants the fucking housing market to crash right now. You got a house? Enjoy.
Give it to me.
You try to buy a house? It's over. We're done.
Also, the
squats,
gas.
Squats, right? What is it? Squatters, right?
2030.
Facts.
The only way to get a house is by competing in a Mr. Beast game show.
Facts, bro. Coming to Amazon.
Only in America. Shout out to Jeff Bezos.
Only in America.
Only in America. No, you see what I'm saying? None of that works.
Like
none
it, of like that. It, like
that's what I said.
But with the anthem, it makes it work.
Yeah. How about this? You go now.
No,
you
can't, go.
You got to do it, though. Nah, push the button. Which button is it? I'll do it for you.
I guarantee if you say
anything.
Let's say gibberish.
Okay, watch.
And it's going to sound fucking amazing.
Watch. Go. Play it. Play it one more time.
I like it when you do it.
One last time. Just play it. Just play it. Watch.
Basketball.
No.
India.
No. Okay, can I get a number one large with ice?
Let me get a pizza pepperoni.
Hey, I'm walking here.
I need my plumbing being fixed right
That's
now.
That's what I'm saying, man. I didn't touch that woman.
Let me get 12 Mexicans so they can build my house.
I don't have any money. I need money, but you
I
don't
need
use
my
cash.
Money now.
I am negative 33 on my account.
Oh my God. Are you okay? Keep it going,
actually,
America.
Actually, negative 33 in your account is very American.
How about this? When's the last time you went on vacation, America? You never did. Because we are the land of the free.
Free.
You
Why should
go
I?
Vacation. You're in vacation.
This is the vacation that the other countries wish they had. Yes.
We are in the Matrix.
What's your favorite fucking day of the week?
Monday.
Wednesday.
Because your ass got to get back to work and back, collect that overtime.
Because we have to go back to contribute to capitalism.
Yes.
That's See? Why.
Feel good. Take a deep breath.
Bukele should be the president of the world.
America. Hey, yo. Shout out to my guy. One more time.
Oh, my God.
No, do it again. We got it up. What are we talking about?
I don't know what we're talking about. We just play the national anthem like 5 times. This is straight up American propaganda in this episode.
Motherfucker. Play one more time.
Oh, my God. One more time.
One more term.
One more term. America. You want to tell me that I got to ban TikTok?
What?
Yo, the reason we popping is because the Chinese people said we like these Americans.
Facts.
Without them, we don't have us.
And what are you going to do with all this TikTokers not making money anymore?
That's what I'm saying, dog. You're going to take America, you're going to take away the hard-earned money from these hard-working Americans?
Shaking their asses?
All because the Chinese people don't want you in their business?
What?
Leave them alone.
Facts.
We got nukes.
We got Chinese food restaurants everywhere.
China said, you got nukes. And we saw what you did to my cousin Japan a couple years ago. But you're not doing it to us.
You're not doing it to us.
So here's TikTok.
Use TikTok.
Here you Facts. Have TikTok.
Shout out to Shao. What's his name?
I don't know.
What is the dictator's name?
Shibibi.
Shogun?
Shy something. I don't want to say what he doesn't like, but people say he look like Winnie the Pooh a little bit.
A little bit.
And that's American name. Shout out to Walt Disney.
I guarantee you, have you seen his shirt?
Xi Jinping.
Xi Jinping.
America is here.
Shout out to you, Xi Jinping.
He looks like the father from Rush Hour. He lost his daughter.
Yes, he does.
Yes, he does.
He does look like the father from Rush
Hour. Like a man. Fight like a man.
Oh, my God. This is. I'm sorry, guys. You guys, after this episode, you guys are going to feel very patriotic. If you don't.
Hey, works, it works,
you
man.
Know what's going to happen after this last video that you play right now with America as the background?
We are not doing that again.
Look, what I'm telling you is, this is what we're going to fucking do. We're going to go out November 24th, and we're going to pick the best candidate for this country.
Facts.
It doesn't matter if they're a puppet. It doesn't matter if there's a whole Supreme Court behind them that really pulls the strings and makes sure that us hardworking Americans can't afford our groceries.
Or it doesn't matter if he's falling asleep. It doesn't matter if he can go up the stairs to his own fucking plane.
Yeah, Joe Biden? Don't matter if it's Joe Mama.
It doesn't matter if his son snorts coke on the fucking Oval Office. It doesn't matter.
Guess what? Because at the end of the day, shit's not going to get done regardless.
At the end of the day, we as a country are the best reality show going on for the world right now.
Yeah. You just bought a house for 45% interest rate?
What?
Congratulations.
Facts.
You played yourself.
You played the fuck out of yourself. Yeah. But guess what? You're contributing to this game called America.
Hosted by Mr. Beast.
And on November 24th.
Available on Prime TV soon.
Sponsored by Feastables. Bruh.
You this got message brought to you by Xi Jinping.
Yes.
Perfect. Beautiful.
This
beautiful.
Is God.
Cherry on top.
I can do this all day.
Cherry all right, man. We're banning the fucking American button for the rest of the episode. Yes. Yes. I'm throwing communism on this show now. Yes.
So you support socialism?
Today I do.
How fucking dare you?
No more.
Oh, your own brother.
No more.
That shit is a two-pack of ass.
How dare y'all? I want a picture of Xi Jinping on the motherfucking wall.
Facts.
Hall of Famer right there.
But he's
dog.
The face of communism.
Look at that haircut, dog.
Look at that haircut.
Look
y'all.
At that shit.
Yeah.
He got that.
Yo, he's sleeping.
He's a beautiful man.
Whatever. Can paralyzed people feel a penis? Find out today at 6.
I don't know what the
end. Find out today at 6. Why'd you say at 6?
Because that's how the news used to be back in the day. Bro, nobody watches the news anymore. TikTok is the news, dog.
Yeah, facts.
What do you think about that? Where do you get your news from?
Me?
Yeah, you buy newspapers still?
I don't get news.
You don't know nothing?
No, I just obviously online. That's where? My main source.
Where? Is it American made?
Mm.
I don't know.
Yo, you know.
Twitter.
You know that the Boeing 787s, those big planes that are falling apart in the sky as we speak?
What do you mean falling apart in the sky?
The plane that had the door fucking launch out in the middle of the air?
Oh, yeah, I remember seeing that video.
They are malfunctioning.
Okay, well, I'm telling you this right
as
now.
As a group? As like a bunch of
different
planes?
Shit are the multiple planes because that company decided to cut corners, basically.
Okay.
And they're buying cheaper products.
With airplanes, they decided
for
to cut corners.
Yes, because they're an airplane company.
Well, you know why, right?
To profit for capitalism.
Yeah, well, the thing also because there was their competitor, which I think it was
Airbus.
Airbus?
It was something else.
There's an airplane company called Airbus.
I think so. Yeah. Double check for me, please.
It was another the competitor. They were building the bigger airplanes that they always wanted to build, which was a 787, like something. It's like Samsung creating the Galaxy and okay. Then iPhone creating that. But then Galaxy, let's say Apple is always a step ahead and Galaxy's like, yo, you know what? We have to start making a phone like that. So they decided to cut corners. So that's what happened with American Airlines. They're cutting corners just to try to like catch on to them so they can just, everybody can buy their airplanes instead of. You
know. All that could have been avoided with the word capitalism. Motherfuckers wanted more money in their pockets. Uh-huh. This is the reason why I'm mentioning this, right? There's a guy who worked for that company and saw what it was and what it is now and has proof of all the bullshit that they're cutting corners and they don't give a fuck the people are dying, right?
Oh, so there's a whistleblower.
A whistleblower. That whistleblower decided to have like a lawsuit against this company, right?
Uh-huh.
He goes on TMZ. They start interviewing him. He's saying what's going on and this, that, and the third. And guess what happened a couple weeks ago? They found him in his truck waiting to go to work with a self-inflicted gunshot wound to the head.
Oh, no, they kill.
Hey, no. Nobody said that. Nobody's pointing fingers. But I'm pointing at Boeing because I know somebody there was like, this guy's talking too much.
Mm-hmm.
Here's an envelope full of fucking money.
Putting chemicals in the water that turn the friggin' frogs gay.
Mm-hmm.
And that guy's dead.
Yo, facts.
I swear to God. Look it up, Pete.
How long ago was this?
A couple weeks ago, on the 9th of March.
You know the date. This is important to you?
I saw the video yesterday.
What the fuck?
No, just imagine. You're going to go on a plane. Plane goes down. Oh, shit. It was Boeing. They don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck. 300 people fall off the sky. I don't give a fuck. We drop a nuke for 100,000 people. It don't matter, dog.
A former Boeing employee who blew the whistle on alleged safety problems after the aircraft manufacturing giant has been found dead.
Boom.
John Barnett, 62, died on Saturday from an apparent self-inflicted wound. A coroner in South Carolina in the United States said on Monday.
Telling you, dog.
So, okay. So, this is an obvious assassination, just like an obvious escape from Jeffrey Epstein from jail. How?
No.
Jeffrey Epstein's alive, bro.
No, he's not. He's dead.
He could be alive. But I get what you're saying.
Yeah. And this clearly is, they killed him.
Yeah. They did. They killed him.
Bless your soul.
Thank you.
They definitely killed him.
Yeah.
So,
the dude had proof.
What now? What happens?
Nothing. No, we keep on moving. You know, we're going to go on TikTok tomorrow. And we're going to keep on moving.
And what's happening with this TikTok thing? When is TikTok getting, bye, see you later?
I think they have till the summer to sell it.
Yo, I don't like that, bro.
What?
USA is pushing for TikTok to be sold to an American company.
So they can control it.
So they can. That's wild, man.
But
I'd rather lose TikTok.
How wild is it? Find out. How wild is it? How wild is it? No, I want him to tell me how wild is it. Go.
Uh-huh. Yeah, how wild is it?
No. El Botón.
El Botón.
He changed the colors too, so it wouldn't play no more if I did it. He was like.
Wow.
My fellow co-host here wants to support his patriotism.
How crazy is it that America is trying to push its claws,
big meaty claws,
to China,
big meaty patriotic claws,
because they want us to sell to an American company?
Us as in the China.
I like Chinese food.
I love Chinese food.
I do.
China. I love Rush Hour. I love Jackie Chan.
China.
I love
China.
But as China, I'm saying, China, yo, China. They killed the whistleblower to Boeing 787 because he was. Did I say they killed him? Allegedly, this man whistleblowed the cheap malfunctioning of their company to make profit. And they found this man with a self-inflicted headshot in his car.
And he was about to do a TikTok.
But this is America. Hey guys, trending. Bang! Done. They said, fuck you. We're going to make even cheaper planes.
Yeah.
Imagine you get on a plane with your luggage and the plane's made out of paper.
Oh my God.
This is a paper
and there's
plane.
A giant just doing this.
There's a documentary, I think it's on Netflix or yeah. something, that they talk about that.
What?
Why they keep making the planes like that. Why they keep. Because there's been, during the Trump administration, there was like a lot of errors, remember? If you remember?
I believe, yeah.
With
yeah,
the Boeing?
Yeah. There was a lot of planes always crashing and shit. So Trump had to stop all the flights from that Boeing, from that airplane, and all the stops were stopped. I don't know if you remember.
One good thing he did.
And then because of that. Because of. Damn. You guys, promoter here.
I'm just saying, dog.
So because of. We get it, Craig. You want to suck his dick. We get it.
I don't want
it. Jesus. But, anyways, it was because during that time, right? They stopped, and then ever since, I think a year later, I think Netflix made a documentary about it, talking about why they were crashing and shit like that, and there was a lot of people like him talking about it, and why they were skipping corners and shit like that. Which I think is a pretty interesting thing, too.
But is it just to save money?
No, to make more money.
No, it was okay, to catch up to their competitors.
So this is they doing this knowingly that people could potentially die.
Yep.
Damn, that's why they got sued and they paid billions of dollars.
You know what doesn't make sense about planes? Think about planes, right? When they were first made by the Wright brothers, right? It was two guys with sticks with like blankets on them, right? And they started flying. And then they said, let's make this better. And then it got better. And then they were like, let's cut some corners. And they're slowly going back. Why? Think about it. Why?
That's crazy.
Why are we going back in time? We need to accidentally find the people that work at Boeing in their vehicles with self-inflicted wounds.
Probably because all these people that are creating the spaceships are making it harder for these airplane companies to get their parts. So the aerospace companies are making all these materials for planes go higher so the airplanes can be extinct, and everything that the humans can do is just buy those spaceships. Fuck. Take trips there.
I'm floating right now.
Let's float away until next week, guys.
Yeah, guys. We're done for today.
I got a piss like a racehorse.
See you guys next week.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here with us. Love you guys.
Oh, he's running.